The chairperson of the Presidential Advisory Committee on Exports and Industrial Development, Odrek Rabogo, has engaged the country's exporters on value addition and working together to improve the quality and standard of their products. This meeting attracted exporters in different sectors, including coffee, beef, dairy, banana, among others. Rabogo maintained that the government is more than ready to support all the creativity and innovation which will lift the country's exports.
Coffee, I can create value at a tree level, right? I don't need to plant more coffee trees if I can augment the planted coffees to give me more. That's value addition. I can also add value at drying or hulling. I can also add value at transportation in a unique way.
Following President Museveni's recent visit to Serbia, where a Uganda trade hub was opened, Rabogo concluded that next month they are to conclude with more negotiations to give a leeway to the Ugandan products in this country.
We're expecting a delegation of ministers end of next month to negotiate a comprehensive tax entry agreement into Serbia for coffee, tourism, for our products.
The mini survey report findings into the country's exports was unveiled, and it indicated that the majority of the exporters are young players who need more financial support.
We realize that our exporters fall in the bracket of 2 to 10 years in business. So which shows that our sector has a lot of the young people. So from the attendance today, we realize that the export landscape has both the big players, and we appreciate what they do, but we also have a big concentration of the young players. And as per said, we're trying to drive that, to drive and ensure that the young players get better fitted in the market.
The exporters made several demands, including the need for the government to put agents in each of the countries where Uganda exports its products, extend more finances to them, and remove all the trade barriers which sometimes deter the smooth flow of the products.
We failed in the past because we did not have a helping hand. And thanks to PACID that we're able to stand up and talk with pride, because today we know what we're doing and we know where we're going. And we look forward, we see the light in the tunnel, and we think definitely it cannot be a train coming in there. It should be something good that we're looking forward to.
Youth, whom we use that as outgrowers to grow cassava, we buy fresh cassava roots from them and we process it into high quality cassava flour, which is now used by confectionaries and bakeries. The challenge we have is the production of cassava is still low compared to demand.
Export growth in Uganda has over the last decade been impressive. The plan to increase the annual exports to $6 billion, excluding oil exports, between 2023 and 2028 from the current average of $3.5 billion. Report compiled by Jaliat Namwaya for the news.